They were the band that changed music forever. The Beatles performed in the Twin Cities nearly 60 years ago. Joe Mazin spoke to a man who met the Fab Four on that trip for this week's So Minnesota.
It was on this tree-lined street in the St. Paul Highland Park home where he had a Leave It to Beaver upbringing.
It was a nice, easygoing neighborhood. It was really like what you'd see in the TV shows, the old TV shows. I fell in love with music at a young age.
In the early 60s, Ron Butwin played drums in his own band. His love for rock and roll came after hearing an English band on the radio.
All of a sudden, we heard this music, and I thought, what the heck is this? What's going on here?
Here are the Beatles!
The Beatles.
This is really unique.
In 1965, while working at B Sharp Music Store, Ron learned the Beatles were going to perform at the Metropolitan Stadium.
They're the biggest thing in the world right now for music.
A group at the store came up with an idea to meet their idols.
God, the Beatles would love this guitar.
They decided to give this Rickenbacker guitar to George Harrison as a gift.
Who knew that it was going to be the hit of the press conference?
With a little help from a friend in the music business, Beatles management agreed to accept the guitar at a press conference before the show.
And now we have a big surprise for you. And all their heads went, you know, like, oh, there's a surprise.
Ron and a co-worker from the music store presented the guitar to George.
Then we said, this is for George. And George leaps out of his seat.
That's great, man.
He's so excited.
That's marvelous. Well, that's fine.
We were excited. I mean, both of us were trembling. And then we went to Paul next, and he said,
it's great. You got one for me?
I wish we had one for everybody.
And then we got to John, and John was like this. Did you bring one for me? No, we're very sorry. Oh. We got to Ringo. And being a drummer, I said, Ringo, it's so fun to meet you after all this time. And then he says, yeah, but did you bring me a drum kit? You know. But he was kidding, you know.
Ron saw the Beatles perform that night. But he could barely hear them.
You couldn't hear much. I mean, it was so loud. Kids were screaming. They never stopped.
Metropolitan Stadium was located where the Mall of America now sits. Every time Ron comes here, he thinks back on that day, all those years ago.
Comes up forever. When I meet people, other musicians, they'll say, well, who's the biggest musician you met? Well, it's really four. Who? The Beatles. And then they just look at you like, what? Come on, you never met the Beatles. You know, that's... This is at the actual press conference. This guy here in the light jacket is me.
Ron has photos from that day, along with a thank you letter he received, signed by George Harrison.
My son and his generation, my daughter and her generation, and even my grandkids who are very young, know who the Beatles are. Oh, yeah.
On one yesterday, four lads from Liverpool gave a magnificent musical memory in the day of the life of a kid from St. Paul. Joe Mazin, 5 Eyewitness News.